Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir.
It's pronounced as Arth.
Yes, sir.
Where do you stay now?
Sir, right now in Gwalior, sir. Gwalior.
Gwalior. But your address is this one?
Sir, it got changed between mains and the results, sir. Sir, during the time I was giving mains, I was in Delhi, sir. After that, my father got transferred. So, right now I'm in Gwalior.
Now, father is still serving?
Yes, sir. He's in IPS, sir.
But is written after retirement? If retired, indicate the post by him held at the time of retirement. You're written Transport Commissioner, Madhya Pradesh.
Oh, sir. I'm not sure, sir, but the form was filled correctly and this hasn't been pointed out before, sir.
He's which batch?
89 batch, sir.
89 batch. Okay. So, he was posted in Delhi also?
Yes, sir. Before
where?
This. Sir, in MP Bhavan.
MP Bhavan. And you stayed in where? Near Hotel Leela Palace, means?
Yes.
New Motiba. And what is the business your mother is doing?
So, she is managing director of an investment bank, sir.
So, this transport commissioner post is in Bhopal or?
So, the main office is in Gwalior or there is an additional office in Bhopal also, sir.
You have done BTEC mechanical from IIT. Recently, last year there was some case involving chief secretary of Delhi. You know that? Some assault case? Some assault case was there. What is latest on that now?
Sir, the allegations against the chief minister and his aides have been dropped, sir.
Now, what is going on now? What is latest on that?
I'm not sure, sir. As far as I know, they have been given a clean chit, sir.
But no, I think cases have been filed against MLAs.
I'll have to check on that, sir.
Delhi getting learner's license, how difficult it is?
Sir, it was difficult, but now faceless services have been introduced and I think they'll significantly make it easier, sir. These RTOs where the learner's license is given, they're known to be very bureaucratic in their approach and a lot of middlemen are there. But with the faceless services, I think it will become significantly easier, sir.
Whether police has got some role to play there?
Sir, it's a uniformed service, but it's not police, sir. Like the case with MP, the RTOs are uniformed because they have to carry out border inspection, but they're not a part of regular police, sir.
So, what is your father's job as a transport commissioner?
Sir, it's a supervision of all RTO offices with regards to services like issuance of learner's license, driver's license, issuance of permits, and overall implementation of Motor Vehicles Act, sir.
Okay, so does he also find there in MP that a lot of corruption takes place in the RTO offices? And what is being done to improve that, like in Delhi?
Sir, interestingly, he introduced faceless just 2-3 months back. Before Delhi got it, he introduced faceless services for learner's license, for renewal of license, as well as for permits, sir.
But I think Delhi, it is some 8-20 services, it is faceless.
So in Delhi, about 35 services out of 37, except for the driving license issuance, has been made faceless. In Madhya Pradesh right now, other services are in pilot projects, sir, as far as I am aware.
Okay, so in MP, previously corruption was there, now it is little going down.
In context of RTO offices?
RTO offices.
Definitely, with faceless coming.
And your mother is in investment.
So she helps companies raise capital, particularly in the solar energy sector, sir.
Okay. Have you heard of Fund of Funds?
It was a part of the liquidity measures announced by government for MSMEs, sir.
Fund of Funds?
Yes, sir. In general, a Fund of Funds
means what?
Sir, basically we have daughter funds and we have parent funds. So the parent funds supports the daughter funds. That is, as far as I understand, that is called a fund of funds.
If I want to make an investment in shares or in mutual funds in some companies of US, is it possible for me to do it sitting in here?
In Gujarat Gift City, you can now do it in the IFSC, but otherwise, I'm not sure, sir.
That is the direct investment, but through mutual funds, can you do it? Or it is there already for the mutual funds. Okay. Delhi Phase 4 Metro. Any idea about that? How long you stayed in Delhi?
Oh, sir, about from 2004 till 2020, sir.
4 to 20, 16 years. So you must be knowing about metro. Phase 4 is coming now.
New line, sir, I'm aware. The pink line and the magenta line. They are.
That is the 3. Now 4 is from, 1 is from Aerocity to Tughlakabad. A number of trees are being cut. Any idea?
I'll read upon this, sir. I'll.
It's coming in newspaper.
Yes.
Acha. Have you heard of FAQs? What are FAQs? FAQ.
Frequently asked questions. Yes, sir.
Where we find that?
Sir, on websites, sir, regarding any public delivery, public service delivery, or any organization, sir, whenever people have to interact with an organization or with a body.
But that is not given in the legislation, rules, or regulations. Why these are required?
So it's to make it convenient for people, sir.
If they are not able to understand through the regulations.
Sir, it's based on the idea that that most people would have similar kind of doubts with regards to a service, and hence it's easier to outrightly point it out, sir.
With some examples.
Yes, sir.
Earth. This solar energy investments you were talking about. Can you tell me about the recent developments in the solar sector in the country?
So we have touched almost 41 gigawatt of renewable energy in solar sector, sir. As part of our targets, we have set around 450 gigawatts for total renewable energy, of which the major portion is solar. Our Prime Minister said about solar energy that solar energy is sure, pure and secure. And the recent schemes include the PM Kusum scheme for solarization, as well as the mega solar plant. For example, in Rewa, it has been announced.
Any major private players entering the solar energy sector? Any development in that regard? Reliance, Adani, any idea? You are not aware of this. What are the EV, electric vehicle related startups in India? Electric motorbikes, anything you are familiar with? Is Tesla entering India?
Sir, it's in talks right now. Recently, there was a news that successfully the customs duty for vehicles above $40,000 and for below $40,000 has been reduced by different amounts.
Okay.
So it is believed that Tesla could enter Indian market, sir.
Okay. So now one of your hobby is what do you call debating. If I give you a topic, will you be able to debate? IC engine versus electric vehicle engines, EV engines.
So first I'll speak for electric vehicles, electric engine. So I'll say that we have major advantages for electric vehicles, like one, they're less polluting, two, less air pollution, two, there is less noise pollution, three, the economic efficiency in the long run is much higher for electric vehicles, and fourth, the chances of failure for electric vehicles is much less since they have less rotating parts. However, now I'll shift to IC engine because there are certain disadvantages of electric vehicles. For example, the overall price is much higher. Second, sir, the range is much lesser, which leads to a phenomenon called range anxiety. Third, I would say the top speed is also lesser, which basically makes it a less of a highway-friendly car, sir. Even when I talk about production, we have certain constraints, like the battery needs raw materials like lithium, nickel, and cobalt, and our charging infrastructure is not there.
So, most of our IC engines are being imported, right? So, we will have to import EV engines as well?
So, the raw material, right now we do not have sufficient domestic capacity, sir.
You worked at a NGO, Arohan. What is the process for registering an NGO? What are the legal provisions that deal with NGOs?
We have the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act that deals with the regulations made to NGO. We have the NGO Darpan portal under Niti Aayog, sir.
Okay. Now, you have written classical, anti, and bug house. What is this? What are the differences?
So, classical is the normal variation of chess. Anti chess is losing chess, basically, where the person who sacrifices his pieces the fastest wins. And bug house is two versus two player chess. So, there are two players on one side and two on the other side. It's played on two boards parallelly.
Okay. So, which is your favorite? So, how does it influence the game? How does bug house, the way of playing, influence the game? Right.
Sir, that is, it said that it does negatively impact our tactical thinking ability because it's more of the fun variant. And the disadvantage is that pieces can...
So, is it like tennis where one player of one team plays first and second, or it's a collaborated effort?
So, two boards are placed side by side and the pieces killed on one board, they can get transferred to the second board, which is what makes it fun yet compromises on the tactical aspect, sir.
Okay, interesting. Appointment of police chief in Delhi. There are some controversies. Can you elaborate on this?
So recently, Mr. Rakesh Asthana was appointed as the police chief. However, the controversy was that he's a Gujarat Cadre Officer 1 and that the deputation, inter-cadre deputation was given specifically for this purpose, and 2, that he had less than 6 months left for his service, sir, which was against a Supreme Court directive.
What is your take? Should it have been done?
As long as it improves the overall quality of policing in a state, I believe that public interest does override a lot of things. At the same time, sir, the government should put out clearly and very transparently why it was done, so that no one feels that any injustice happened, sir.
Okay. One more question. Oscars. What is the status of Oscars right now? Oscars, post-COVID, how has it impacted Oscars?
Sir, it has had a negative impact because Oscars was famous for basically shops as well as eateries. And the major clientele for Oscars were the colleges and universities around it. Since because of the lockdown as well as the colleges being closed, a lot of small businesses have been closed in Oscars, sir.
So anything functioning in Oscars right now?
I haven't visited, so I would not be able to tell, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Where is this?
The R1 NGO. Ma'am, it was part of our NSS, so it was taught within the premises of college.
Okay. And what were the methods you adopted in teaching maths to these
students? Ma'am, we had to restrict ourselves to chalk and board. So basically, I would supply them with quizzes as well as materials. I would ask them to come after having had an initial reading. Then I would test them with different questions and teach them theory on Blackboard.
On Blackboard, then they were not able to see. So, how were you doing that?
Sorry,
so, Blind Women, National Association for Blind Women.
Ma'am, that is different. I worked in.
That's what I was asking. That taught mathematics at Aruban NGO under NSS. Okay, that's separate. Volunteered at National Association for Blind Women.
Yes, ma'am, that's different.
That's what I got. And then what were you doing here with the Blind Women Volunteered at National Association?
Ma'am, helping them with their everyday activities, so which could include that teaching them using a computer or working in the arts and crafts department, because NAB is famous for taking part in the blind school Mela. So they have to make arts and crafts over the year. They have to study for the exams. So this is where we volunteers would come in.
So for example, if you're teaching them computers, so we use this different kind of keyboard or something for these, with people who can't see?
No, ma'am. Interestingly, the same keyboard and the same computer was used, except that speakers were on all the time.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, it's amazing to see how much they had come. They were able to type flawlessly because they knew where the keys were positioned.
When they used to click it, the sound used to come, then this is the key which they had clicked. So, mm-hmm. How they used to know whether they are typing it correctly or not?
Ma'am, if we have the keyboard, for example, we know that the keys are in a particular order, like Q, W, E, R, T, Y. So once you know the edge of the keyboard, you can find out, you have a basic idea, a mental image in your mind where the other keys would be. Ma'am, that is why I said it's extremely interesting to see how they were flawlessly typing, even without the use of sound. The sound was mostly for the newcomers, ma'am.
Okay, suppose they learn computers, what after that? Will
Ma'am, the computer was meant for making everyday life smoother for them. It was basically an essential skill that was being given. But to the second part of your question, yes, NAB did something spectacular. They brought two special treatments. One is the discovering hands, and second is the Japanese therapy. Both basically rely on the superior tactile perception of people who are visually impaired. So because of this, industries were actively looking for these women and hiring them.
Okay, which city would you like, would you prefer to live in, Delhi or Bombay?
Ma'am, both have their own advantages. I think Delhi being the capital, it gives you exposure to a lot of cultures. It has better public health facilities, education facilities, as well as the overall infrastructure. But when I see Gwalior, the life is calm and relaxed. There is a lot of greenery all around, and even the air is cleaner. So ma'am, it would be difficult for me to choose.
Okay, but then you have opted for Delhi as your
option. The career has been allocated based on the criteria which was given in the form, ma'am.
Yes. The three biggest problems in Delhi, which still needs to be addressed and has been ignored so far.
But one, I would say, is the crime rate, particularly crimes against women.
Mm-hmm.
Two would be the issue of traffic, and three would be issue of air pollution.
So, if you are there, then which are the things you would like to address first? Which is going to be in your priorities?
First would be, ma'am, definitely crimes against women, because.
So, how do you think that you can address this problem, and why is Delhi government failing?
Ma'am, first I'll answer what can be done. So I think in the short term, we have to improve the overall infrastructure, like lighting in areas, CCTV cameras, deployment of marshals in buses, installation of panic buttons, increasing police patrolling. Other long-term measures could be that improving the overall investigation and increasing the conviction rate, addressing the issue of alcohol and drugs so that the overall crime rate reduces. As to the second part, ma'am, why this is happening, I would say it's a combination of increasing unemployment, increasing use of alcohol and drugs, as well as increasing mobility and the infrastructure deficiency, which makes it slightly unsafe for women, ma'am. Also, as NCRB has pointed out, that in 98% of the cases, women knew their perpetrator, so which makes it difficult to prevent a crime per se. It becomes more of an administrative issue rather than of policing.
So, do you think that as an administration, respective of Delhi, Haryana, we usually ignore this issue? This has never been a priority, women's safety?
Ma'am, I would not say so, especially after the Nirbhaya case. Every case of assault is treated extremely seriously. A lot of reforms have taken place, right from EFIR to mandating FIR. Right now, the SHO can be suspended if he refuses to file the FIR. Certain new provisions are also added in IPC. So although we have a long way to go, a lot of changes have taken place. Like recently, the number of marshals were deployed in buses. So definitely, ma'am.
Okay. Last question about debate. So as a nation, do we shy away from debates?
Ma'am, I would not say so. Personally, I feel that we have an extremely thriving and inclusive debating environment. We have people debating literally everywhere, from drawing rooms to news channel rooms, to the parliament as well.
So have you watched US presidential debates?
I have heard about this. I have heard about those, ma'am.
Have you seen?
Not really, ma'am.
So do you think that we, India, should also follow this form of debates for elections?
I think, ma'am, we can, because it would allow people to know more about the candidates, their thought process, their views, and most importantly, that people often feel the existing speeches are a PR exercise, but a debate would help people know the true picture of a candidate, the underlying thoughts of a candidate, so it would improve the overall quality.
Statistics also part of your mathematics learning? Okay, what is an irrational number?
Sir, a number of which cannot be expressed in the form P by Q.
Okay. Can an irrational number be drawn on the number line?
Sir, as far as I understand, it can't be because the exact value of irrational number is not known, sir. For example, if we take pi, so it starts with 3.141257, but it's never ending. So the exact...
Are you sure? Okay. What is complex number?
So complex number is a number of the form a plus iota b, where one part is real and the other part is imaginary.
What is the practical application of complex number?
Sir, as far as I know, it's used in control theory and circuits, sir. But
okay. Circuits, in what way it will help? It helps in what?
So the complex numbers? Not sure, sir. Not sure.
Okay. Again, tell me what is the practical application of Lagrangian equation.
Sir, I'm slightly forgetting the Lagrangian equation.
Remember, there is something called Lagrangian equation.
I'm forgetting, sir. I'll have to read up on this.
So, options only studied for mains only. After that, you forgot. Can I take it in that way?
So the Lagrangian and Hamiltonian equations?
Ah.
Yes, sir, they are used for...
That is Cayley and Hamilton theorem, that is different.
So
Lagrange is little different.
Cayley-Hamilton theorem is in group theory, sir.
Okay, what is...
In modern algebra.
What is the practical application of Cayley-Hamilton theorem? What is the theorem? You explained to us in a layman's word, what is the general term?
Sir, if we take any square matrix, it satisfies its own characteristic equation. That is the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Basically, A is a matrix, then A minus lambda I.
Okay, that is again Greek and Latin. Layman cannot understand A minus lambda I. So, practically, where it can be used?
I am not sure, sir. I'll read up on this.
Okay. What are all the recent reforms the government has initiated to improve trading across borders?
Not sure, sir. I'm not aware.
To improve ease of doing business?
It's less. As well as I think the single window portals have been created. Input tax credit process has been made easier, as well as the insurance coverage.
What are the components of ease of doing business index?
So getting permit, registering a business, electricity, then protecting minority investors. These are among some of the components, sir.
Privacy, why it is a fundamental right?
It prevents any undue or unnecessary interference in our lives. It ensures our autonomy. It's crucial for us to exercise our own liberty, devoid of any unnecessary interference.
So, how it is made fundamental right? That's what I think. How?
Sir, it was declared as a fundamental
what
right.
What is the
case
analogy
case,
they have taken? How many fundamental rights are there? So, under which right?
Under Article 21, sir, they took a liberal or expanded understanding of Article 21. They said that right to life and liberty. The
okay, your interview is over.